Hello and welcome to this overview of GloRyder's self-generating wheel lights. You can see we have this set up for cars, Polaris Slingshot, and Can-Am Spyder here. So when you receive your package, there are a number of things that you're going to need to do before you put this on your vehicle. All right, so we've gone ahead and taken one of the units out of the package here, and let's just go over some basic features. Now you'll hear this ratcheting noise as you unscrew the bottom here. And there's a reason for that, and that is because there is a ball spring plunger on each side here. So that's a spring-loaded ball bearing. And what it is, as you tighten it down, those ball bearings ratchet up into these little cavities here and hold the unit in place so that it doesn't come loose during vibration. Now you'll notice also that the top cap comes off, and that's for ease of use to change the battery inside. Now you'll notice here that the center is not spinning as I'm turning it, and there's a counterweight in there, so it should be spinning because that's how it generates electricity. So you'll notice that there's a little piece of foam inside here behind that clear plastic. So what you're going to do, you're going to look for this little indentation in here, and that's to get your fingernail inside there. So just kind of pry that loose very gently and just kind of work your way around it. Make sure that that bottom comes off. So just remove the top. You'll notice here there's going to be a little battery clip. We're going to get into that in a little bit. But here's the reason why that unit's not turning. So the first thing that you need to do is pull this little piece of foam out of the bottom. And now you can see that the unit turns freely. Now that's something that we just put in there for packing. So let's draw your attention here to this switch. So by default, it's in the off position. The circuit board will not work while this is in the off position. So take your fingernail and just push it over to the on position there. And you'll be able to tell that when you put your battery in there because these lights will go through a cycle. So let's just demonstrate that real quick here so that you can see. Let's set it to the off position. So you'll put your battery in and you'll notice that there's no lighting that comes on with it. And if you turn it on, you'll notice that the lights do light up. So that's a very important feature. The circuit board, in order to work correctly, if it does not turn on when you turn the switch on, it means that the battery is either dead or it's not seated properly. So the first thing that you're going to do is make sure that the switch is turned into the on position. So take your battery, set it inside the unit, and turn the switch on. Now, I want to show you something because each battery manufacturer is a little different in their sizing. Now, if I take this battery out and say I change my battery here, okay, the lights came on and that's great. But sometimes when you put a battery in, you won't see the lights cycle on. You may have to put the battery in two or three times. In this particular case, this is sized very well and it's making a good connection there. So I can't really emulate that right now, but let's bring in another circuit board and see if we can make it happen with that. So let's see. Okay, and it's working great with that one as well. So, but every once in a while, I'm telling you, you will put a battery in and the lights will not come on. So don't be afraid, the unit is not broken. Okay, so I was able to do it there. Just make sure that when you put it in, that those lights light up and it goes through that cycle. Then you know you're ready to go. Now, since we're talking about electronics here, let's go ahead and go over the remote control. All right, so the remote control, you can tell that the battery is in it because if you press one of the buttons, you'll see that the light comes on. And that indicates that the battery's in it. So I'm holding my fingers over this because I've unscrewed these screws in the back. If your unit does not come with batteries and you need to change the battery, now you should get a battery because we're going to include one in every package. But when it's time to change the battery, here's what you're going to do. Of course, unscrew these four small screws in the back and you're going to take the battery out, positive and negative. The negative side has the spring in it. So let's just pop that out. And you'll notice there will be a light that comes on. Hopefully you can see it here when I put the battery in there, but there's a little flash. You'll see that when you put a battery in, the light will flash, and that's how you know that this circuit board is working correctly. Try to open it like this, take the back off, and if you do it the other way and you turn it over, the unit might fall out, the circuit board might fall out and land on the ground and break or something like that. So try not to do it that way. And then when it's time to put it back together, just make sure that it's all lined up correctly. It might take a little bit of fidgeting. It's probably better to take the screws out and you should be able to just snap it in there. Okay, so there you go. Okay, so now it's lined up correctly. Go ahead and just, you know, tighten down the screws. We're not going to go through too much trouble right now, just because we want to move on with the video, but put those four screws inside there. Now, the way that the remote control works, this is your on button. This is your off button. So up is on, down is off. And then you want to lock in the different colors on the remote control. So let's press this button and see if this is paired to this remote control. Okay, this one is not paired to this remote control. How can we reprogram this so that it works correctly? You're going to hold down that little lock button and you'll see these lights will begin to flash. That means it has received the program and it is ready to rock and roll. So how do you change the color? Well, let's go ahead and flip to a different color. So we got blue there. Let's lock it in. So you lock in the color here, send it to the remote control by the square. This is the send button. This is the color button. Now, another thing that's important is there's a cycle time in this remote control. If you're used to clicking your remote controls really quick, you're gonna find that you need to slow down when you use this. So switch to a different color. Let's go to red. And you'll notice that that cycle is going through there. If you press it while the light is still on, it's not gonna work. So wait till the light goes off and then you're ready to switch it to a different color. And it's the same thing with on and off. So let's switch it to a color and try to turn it off real quick here. So now you notice, see, it takes a couple of seconds to turn off. And that's because it has to finish the cycle. So if you turn it on and try to turn it off too quick, it's not going to do it. So let it go through its cycle, and the way that you know is the light will go out and then you can do whatever you need to do with it. Okay, so that's the basic function of the remote control and the circuit board. An optional battery clip is available from our store at GloRyder if you need it. But in general, we find that most of the time you should not. In all of our tests, the battery stayed in very well. However, if you happen to live in an area that has very bumpy roads or a lot of potholes on the highway, we do have this available. The way that you would install it is by placing it over the battery until you hear it clip into place. There's two little clips on each side. You will need a tool to remove it. And we don't recommend that you use one with a sharp edge like this. Instead, try to use a very small Phillips screwdriver. The way that you would remove it is by putting it in the side of the clip and just bending it out and lifting it up in the air a little bit and doing the same thing on the other side. Then get your thumb under there and lift it out. You have to be very careful that you don't bend this receiver circuit board. If you do, you may break the unit and then that will void your warranty. So the clip is available if you need it. In most cases, you will not. All right, so let's talk a little bit about batteries. Now you can see we have one installed here, but your unit will not come with this installed. It's likely going to come in a separate package inside the box, and it'll have your batteries inside there. So you'll need to install those. Now, this is a small 16340 lithium ion battery. It's rated at 650 milliamps. And to say that some of the manufacturers take advantage of folks that don't know about the true capacity of batteries is to put it nicely. We've seen some of these batteries marked at 3000 milliamp hours and it's just not true. Don't fall for it. It's just a gimmick to try to sell batteries. In general, you probably won't find a reliable battery at much more than about 800 milliamp hours. So when you're looking for batteries, if you're looking for replacements, you want a higher capacity battery. We do sell these on our store, and we'll continue to update you on better batteries as we find them, the most reliable batteries. But we've done a lot of research into this charger, this battery, and this charger as well. So these are available on our store, the Xtar VC4 and the Light Ocala, I hope I'm saying that right. Those are available, and they do have faster charging rates. So when you get your batteries, you're gonna wanna stick them inside your charger. Now this is the charger that we're including. This is an older used version. You'll have a nice brand new one. But this will take several hours to charge the batteries, and that's because it charges at about 250 milliamps per slot here. Now some of the more expensive ones here, like we sell, they're a very high capacity charger. They have very intelligent software in here, and it'll charge at 250, 500, 700, even 1,000 milliamp hours. You'll have to look at the instructions to understand how to use this. We're not gonna get into that in this video. So that's the basics of the battery. Make sure that you charge it when you get it. Let's talk a little bit about the physics of what we're doing here with this charger. We have about a 2.5-inch area here to put a generator and counterweight inside there. So we're only going to get so much capacity out of that. We had one of our update videos where we showed that if you rode for about 5 to 6 hours continuously, you will get a good charge out of this little generator inside here. But if you're just going to the store on the weekend with your vehicle, or you just use it maybe once or twice a week, you're not gonna get a charge out of that generator inside there. So you will need to use these wall chargers. Now we've made it very easy to access the battery. So if this is on your vehicle, all you gotta do is just unscrew your cap, take the little lens out here, you gotta get your fingernails under there to get it off. And then you can just pull the battery out and stick a new one inside there. And again, you wanna make sure that those lights go on through that cycle. All right, so this has been a brief overview. We think that we're gonna save you some head scratching and a little bit of time by sharing these tips and tricks with you. These are the things that we found as we've been working with them over the last few months. And we hope that you've enjoyed this. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you in the next video.